Alright, what's going on YouTube? But oh, what a PhD, back with another episode. And today, we're not playing Fuero Reich. Oh no, we're playing British Empire Reich. Let's go! So yeah, I don't know who that dude was who just broke into my room and recorded that, but yeah, Fuero Reich, United Kingdom time. Let's go. We are in the Empire, rulers of the world, split between the Continental Entente, the Third International, ourselves, the Imperial Protection Alliance. We have a lot of options here. And of ways we can go to. We can also just do a default Britain move and just ignore all of Europe completely. But I'm pretty sure that we should not do what happened in the last video and just die to the French and the Irish at the same time, because I think there's no bigger humiliation than that. You see, I could intervene in India. Right now, I just feel like a certain trustworthy French man. I just don't feel like it. So the situation has not necessarily developed to Britain's advantage, and we could call new elections, and we could continue democracy, or we could just dissolve the parliament with the military and become authoritarian. Oops. What are you gonna do, Newfoundland, you little bitch? So we can decide if we're gonna keep the Union Jack or take the Royal Standard. I actually don't know what the Royal Standard looks like. Or maybe I do, I just don't know what the name is. I'm just gonna save real quick in case it actually ends up looking worse. Oh, that's what that is. Oh. Oh, no, I'm going back, So for the internal policy in the conference, right? We have a lot of options. Status quo, maybe. Yeah, that's valid. More autonomy. Yeah, maybe. I don't know, for like some authoritarians, more autonomy, really. Or Imperial Federation. I don't know. Maybe the status quo would... Oops. Oh yeah, Ireland. Maybe they must be given independent... Oops. My finger slipped. Oh, the Japanese won't have an alliance. I don't know. Maybe I don't... Oops. My finger slipped again. Oh, would you look at that. Yet another Boer War. Oh, we had to do this 3 times already, and now we're gonna do this again. God damn it. India decided to collapse again, but fear not, because the Empire is here and ready to take the fight back to India, right? Don't mind me, I'm just doing some Empire building real quick. I'll be right back, guys. First conflict, Germany declared war against the new Czechoslovakia, and they're not backed by the French, actually. So they don't really have a chance. Very interested how the war is gonna end on the continent, because the last few times, every time Germany goes after a single neighboring country, they get blocked by the French and they just die. So I wonder if that's gonna happen again. Okay, we got brand new news. Italy, without any German intervention, actually also went Folktist. And now they're at war with them somehow. I don't know what happened. But the two Folktist nations are at war. They're not teaming up. They're at war with each other. Yeah, so there are two scenarios. Either they block the Germans in the mountains or they're dead. Oh yeah, I don't think the Italians were ready for this. Okay, I think the Germans are gonna have an interesting key game. So I'm still building up, but the Germans, they're going all in this time. Especially since the French and the Italians. Italy, I mean, you know that if we sell Malta to Italy, we're indirectly gonna sell it to the Germans, right? So, no, thank you. I think you have bigger things to deal with than Malta, I'm pretty sure. Okay. Wait, Serbia? What the fuck? Why is Serbia involved here? Why did Serbia get... What? In Spain? What happened to Italy? Oh my god. Ugh, Spain. Ugh. Purple Spain in Italy, what happened? What happened? Alright guys, World War 1 Part 2, are you ready? Because I am not, but I guess the French are. But this time it's the French without the Italians. So Germany cannot attack France through the Alps because Serbia is in the middle. What the fuck? Why is Serbia in the Alps? Oh my god. Yeah, if I ever intervene, I need to kill Serbia because I cannot let this border go untouched. And also Spain as well, because what the fuck? So Germany just defeated Poland and the Rhineland, so France stands all on their own. No, I think France is dead. They don't even can't even match up the units. Yeah, so I think the continent is done. I'm not sure if we're gonna meddle or not. We'll see what's gonna happen. So Italy is just a government in exile now, and they only have the colonies, and they apparently formed a faction with Moscow. So they now have the Rome-Moscow axis, even though they are not fascist. One of them is communist, and the other one is kind of fascist, so I don't know how that works. And France is about to die. Oh, wait a second. I can already... Wait, there's another event where I can already take what I want. I don't even need to go to... Okay, never mind. I love how there's just an event for that. Yeah, the French are there. Just take as much shit as you can carry. Okay, Germany's just declaring war against everybody now. They declared war against Denmark, even though they don't bother them. Latvia, Lithuania, Switzerland, they're attacking everybody right now. Oh, Lord. Okay. Okay, maybe I should have... post them. Who knows? Maybe we should have brought the Entente back. So it might be that I just witnessed the creation of a monster that's not gonna stop and attack everything. They're attacking the Ukrainians now too. And then probably they're gonna attack the Soviets next. And we might not even be able to stop them anymore. So France and Germany signed a peace deal. It's over. The French just gave up. The Dutch state looks like this now. The borders have been adjusted. The Ostland exists now. It's really just the Soviets that are the only ones left. So now they're gonna attack the Soviets. Oh, dude, the Germans are so big. Oh my god. Turkey is justifying against us. Oh, yeah. Oh, Bulgaria too. You know what? No, I'm just gonna dip out. I'm just gonna dip out of the Middle East. Do what you want. Yeah, I'm just gonna meddle there because they're in this style pact. I don't want to deal with all of that. Maybe if they fight the Soviets, but not now. Gentlemen, 1941, we are back in action. So let's see who's gonna win. I wonder if the Germans are gonna steamroll them or if it's gonna be balanced. Because they both have about the same amount of divisions. But considering the Soviets go with mass mobe, that doesn't really mean much. Right. I did the Raj first. And for some reason, the Raj got this territory here, but only this, not the rest. I'm not a big fan of it, but instead, I'm gonna do some empire building now too. Because we need to connect the Eastern Holdings with the Western Holdings. So we need to go through Iraq first. And not only Iraq, Iran too. So you know what? I'm just gonna start a war on two sides right now. Okay, so it turns out that Canada and Newfoundland agreed to become part of the Imperial Federation, but Australia, New Zealand, and South Africa did not. So before I'm gonna deal with that, I'm just gonna take over Arabia real quick. Shouldn't take too long. Now I finally united the Middle East. But I cannot release puppets right now because I'm still at war with some of my constituents' countries that I need to take out, like South Africa and Australia. Let me just do that real quick. We once again see that if your units are faster than the enemy's units, you can literally just drive around them and just encircle them and you win by default. I think that was the whole South African army right here. That's like 20 divisions. That's like the majority here. And it took like a few minutes and we got them. And they only have 5 divisions left. GG guys, we did it. One encirclement maneuver later. We got them. So it's time to micro my way into, you guessed it, Australia. It's Australia, not Austria. That is very important. Never get them confused. Otherwise people will get mad. Or do they? Oh yeah, we landed up here too. I almost forgot. Dude, my army is so big. I don't even remember where I'm invading people and where I'm not. I'm gonna invade them from yet another spot. What kind of, wait, what? What place name is that? Wagga Wagga? Okay, Australians, you need to explain to me what the fuck's up with that. Is that like some secret code word for like world domination? Or what the fuck is that? What kind of name is that? Wagga Wagga, my fucking ass. And another one bites the dust. So it's just the New Zealanders left. The America has been at war with Mexico for I don't know how long. The Americans lost 4 million against Mexico. What the hell happened? Okay, well, I need to meddle and just kill the Americans then. Because that is the perfect occasion to do so. So, no, they didn't die. They just signed the peace treaty. Yeah, I'm not even sure if I can even stop them anymore at this point. But I mean, there's only one way to figure it out, right? That's going to be the final goal, to defeat Germany after they control all of this. But they still don't control that much in the end of the day. So once I have the Imperial Federation and I have all the production, I'm just going to try to beat them. The final puzzle piece for the Imperial Federation is New Zealand now. For the grand finale, I can do this. Bam, we did it. We annexed all of Canada and Newfoundland. And we have 77 divisions. And we have 82 million core manpower. So now it's time to defeat the Americans hard. Especially hard considering that I'm gonna attack them using motorized. And especially hard since I lost 4 million against the Mexicans. So we have a lot of possibilities right here. So now we beat America and then we take on Germany. That is the final plan. I don't know how they lost 4 million men here. The Americans are scraping the barrel against Mexico. The border has barely moved for like years. I think this is gonna be very easy. Well, 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 Mr. Long Dong, it would seem to me that your time has come. Bonus on core territory. In vanilla, they have 25%, so this is actually a lot easier than vanilla. Makes me very happy. So let's go break them. Alright, we're overrunning them already. New England is mine, you fucking bitch. It's called New England and not New America, you fuck. You know, maybe you should have changed the name if you didn't want this to happen of this region, you know. We're gonna take the fight to New York. Oh, and Boston, and Massachusetts, and Rhode Island. What's left? Connecticut? We already took that. Oh, dude. And once we get to Wyoming, that's gonna be that difficult. I don't even want to think about Wyoming. Oh, no. We're winning on the east, we're winning on the west, and the Mexicans, they're helping us. So we're gonna divide the borders classic style. The Mexicans are gonna get the territory back. We took Boston, where the American dream began and where we shall put it to an end. Well said, game, well said. Alright, we are going to burn in the White House again. And yeah, Huey Long Dong, he's not doing too well. He used to have 150 division. He already lost 50. And considering that the Mexicans are also pushing, I don't think he was ready for this, was he? Maybe don't lose fucking 6 million men to the Mexicans. I bet the Yanks aren't happy about this.
I'm not sure about that.
I don't know what they were pissed about, that the Brits are coming back, or that they lost 6 million to the Mexicans. And the quest has been completed. They were just, we were about to rendezvous with the Mexicans, but we already won by then. Mexico just got the reward for being good enough to kill 6 million Americans, and I took the rest. And we are done here. So now it's time to go for the ultimate challenge. And now we can use the 4 million manpower that the Yanks have with these Yank divisions and just expand our military even further. I don't know what happened, but for some reason America got one part of France. I don't know when that happened or how that happened. That seems to be like a bug of something, but that's gonna help me for my invasion from Germany. So you know what? I'm just gonna use this to my advantage. I'm about to like plan the largest naval invasion that I've ever done in my entire life, because we have to land here and push east as fast as possible. Well, it's not going to be as large as it could be because of this sliver of land here, but it's going to be freaking huge, dude. I have a total of 288 divisions. I have 72 here on in France. Then I have naval invasions planned with a total of 96 divisions. Okay, so in total we have about 180 divisions, I think, ready to take the continent back. And also I have like some backup divisions in Scotland. Also, once again, Americans, because they have so much manpower. Oh, they keep getting more manpower, dude. I don't know what's happening, dude. I need to train more of those. I'm just gonna train more Americans just for backup. And on top of that, I also deployed, I think, like, what, thousands of planes here in the area as well. So I think we should be good, right? I hope. And once we seize airfields, we can send in more and more of our planes. And I'm also sure, pretty sure the Germans also have more fighters than I do. Yeah, they have like 7k fighters. I have 3.6k fighters. Yeah, I can't even keep up. Most of the puppets barely have divisions, so they're all ineligible. So it's just Germany, basically, and France. Alright, gentlemen, are you ready for presumably one of the largest invasions I've ever done? Because I really, really am. Oh, the Soviets are back! Yo, the Soviets, they know! The Soviets just attacked them right now, this is perfect! I'm just gonna wait now, because the Germans are gonna move all of the units over to Russia. Yeah, they don't even have any units on the border just now. Alright, gentlemen, it is time to move right in. We're able to push them back bit by bit. The Germans have 200 divisions, I have 300 divisions. We still have enough supplies, that's not the issue. 8,000 versus, okay, I think we're having green air. But the air war here is like, absolutely disgusting. I'm now just trying to push. Battle planning again. I don't have enough production for all these fighters, because it's just like a huge air war. But I think the Germans are also heavily losing planes though. Yeah, they used to have 9,000. Yeah, I think we have more planes than the Germans. We shot down 2,000 of their planes. And we're about to get this encirclement down here. Yeah, I think the Germans, I don't even think they can stop us at this point. We're gonna push them back to the mountains. It's 1945. We got a breakthrough up here too. We got some units encircled. The Germans lost 1 million. I lost 500k, the Soviets lost 500k, okay. We are about to cut the German front line into two. And now we just end them down here in southern France. Oh my god, Germany is dying. I think, oh my god, I'm fangirling. I'm actually fangirling. We're doing this. Grand offensive, we're doing it. And the absolute unit of tanks that we have here. Just take them all out. Oh, we already took Berlin. I didn't even realize. Oh my lord. We let the Germans grow and then we just built our own war machine. Just so that we can eliminate them all. So southern France is completely done. They're trying to flee, but they can't flee anywhere. Dude, I swear to god, if Turkey's a major, dude. Oh yeah, they probably are a major, right? Well, I'll get back to that in a bit. So I wonder what the Soviets are doing. They still got units over there, right? So the Germans just lost, I think, 50 divisions or something. So we got all of them encircled. We just take them all out. Now I'm just gonna do a casual encirclement. And with casual encirclement, that doesn't mean right-click encirclement. So you don't even strategically plan, you just right-click where you want to encircle them. And then you just do that. And then your units will just do the rest for you. We're gaining ground so quickly, I constantly need to readjust where my units are pointing. So we're gonna push them all the way towards Italy here. It's gonna be the next plan. Bohemia is dead as well. We split Germany into two, but they still have harbors down here. We're gonna move it down. I think we already got this in the bag, dude. What the fuck? Yeah, Turkey is the other major. They got absolutely torn by the Imperials. This ascended that united peoples from the entire world to end the German continental menace. Isn't it moments like these where humanity comes together for the greater good to defeat one large foe that seems to be unstoppable? It's absolutely magnificent. So the Germans have lost almost half of their divisions. We are getting close. We're getting pretty close. We got the Italian encirclement. The tanks are taking initiative. They're already there in the front lines. German Alpine divisions. I don't even know what the heck they're trying to do. This is going to be the new continental order sponsored by the United Kingdom. Just clean it all up. Clean it all up. Perfect, we just cleaned it all up. Actually, there's a little bit left over here. A little bit of garbage that we need to clean out here. Hold up. So, we have 350 divisions. The Germans have 100. Probably most of those are probably at the Soviet border, now that I think about it, right? We need the French Republic Navy with us? Oh, you're gonna kill the French later on, too. So, we're fighting the Germans in the far east of their empire. Where what's left of it. And Germany will only capitulate when they have 0%. 0%, huh? So, it's all or nothing for the Germans. They do not capitulate early. Well, neither do we. Because we will take the fight to the absolute end. So, we got more cast down. So, this makes it
a lot easier.
I love how it's just to put the cast down and we start gaining ground immediately.
Okay, whatever that Reichskommissariat was, is dead. And now we're in the final territory of Germany. They've got 87 divisions. And the freaking French have landed here, dude. Are you kidding me? Right, let's stick the fight to them. I got enough spare divisions here anyway. The Germans have capitulated, yes. So the Germans are done. So now the next step is defeat the Turks. I think I'm gonna use my tanks for the Turks. Yeah, you know what? Let's just defend Libya so I can kill the French more easily so I don't need to naval invade them. It's time for the Turks to freaking and absolutely die. Alright, just push them to the sea and then we just use that for better front lines. And just drive all over them and then we get them. The Turks are done and we win. We beat them all. Half of my army just went moving up the Caucasus right now. So let's look at the casualties right now. Germans lost 2.6 million, the Turkish 300k. I lost 1 million. But that is okay because we actually did it. The new goddamn world order. Oh yeah, we're not done yet. We're not done yet, actually. As much naval strike damage as possible. And we're also gonna move through Libya here. Just so that we can kill the French more easily. Now we have this. We even have nukes now. Huh, do we have a strat bomber? Yeah, I have strat bombers. Hell yeah, I have strat bombers. I think we probably can nuke the French as well. Libya down. We are here, but that was actually not necessary. Okay, we're gonna nuke the French. Watch this shit. Boom, boom, and tactical nuking as well. Boom. Hell yeah, dude. This is late game hoy. 1946, let's go get them. We hate the French so much, we just fucking nuke them with the first few nukes in the game. And tactical nuking. Here we go. Kaboom. That's how you win the battle. Because they just lose all the org they have. That's how you win a siege, boys. Tactical nuking. So the infrastructure is probably absolute dog shit right now, but... That's part of it. Yeah, this is it. This is the new world order. It's all in red. So now it's just Brittany. This just looks so dumb. The German kingdom and put a Windsor on the throne. This is the new Germany here. Okay. Oh, Lithuania was the one here. Oh, now we have this ugly panhandle again. Oh, not again. And we have here HRH Henry I in charge. All of these here are my puppets. I don't have a faction, unfortunately. Because when I formed the Imperial Federation, it ceased to exist. We did it. We defeated Germany. So George is holding is power in France. Henry in power here. It's pretty good. Wait, the Kingdom of France just made a puppet out of the French Free State and also Occitania? What the fuck did they do? I thought they were united, but they're not united. What the fuck? 5 hours? Did this take me 5 hours? Maybe. It didn't feel like 5 hours, though. So now it's just the Soviets left, basically. Well, what can I say? Bottle Water Productions turned Fuhrer Reich into British Empire Reich. 5 hours, but still fun as fuck. Dr. MK will return.